In this tutorial, we will draw a 2D design and then generate G-code from it. To make the 2D design, we will use Inkscape. And to generate the G-code, we will use jscut.org. So let's start. Step 1. Prepare Inkscape. First of all, you have to start Inkscape. After Inkscape starts, you have to change the document units to millimeters. To do that, click File, Document Properties, and then change the default units and units to millimeters. You can also change the size of the document to 200 by 200 millimeters, but this is not crucial. After you change units and document size, you have to save your document. So click File, Save, and save it to your desktop as Hello World. Step 2. Draw a simple design. Use the Text Object tool to draw the Hello World words. Hello World is now inside your document and is ready to make it look better. Double-click on it. Select all the characters and then from the menu select a better font, like the Aharoni. Although Hello World looks nice, it is very small, so you have to change its dimensions. By holding down the Control key on your keyboard, click the bottom right corner with your mouse and drag as long as you are satisfied with the size. For our tutorial, we will make it 180 by 25 millimeters. Now your design is ready. Select all parts and click Path, Object to Path, which is crucial for the G-code generation. And after that, click on File, Save. Step 3. Generate G-code. With the design ready and saved on your desktop, you are ready to generate the G-code. Open your favorite browser. Go to www.jscut.org and click the Launch button. As soon as JSCut loads, make sure you set the right pixels per inch value. We used Inkscape version 0.91, so we have to put 96 pixels per inch, as JSCut suggests. Next step is to set our units into millimeters by clicking the Make All Millimeter option. If you want to work with inches, then you can just leave the settings as they are. Now it is time to import your design, so click the Open SVG button, select the Local option, and then choose the HelloWorld.svg file from your desktop. Your design is now loaded. Click each letter of the Hello World until everything changes color to dark blue, and then click the Create Operation button. For this design, we will make a simple pocket operation. So choose Pocket and set depth at 2 millimeters. After that, click the Generate button and wait a few seconds for JSCut to generate the G-code. Now you are able to see the G-code results by clicking on the Simulate G-code tab. As you notice, the letter E doesn't look very good. That happened because the end mill we used was thicker than it should be, so we have to use a thinner one. For this operation, we will use a 1 mm end mill, so we change the diameter to 1. We set the pass depth to 0.2, and we set slow, plunge and cut speeds, so we will not break the 1 mm end mill. Now click the Generate button again and wait to see the results. Now everything looks perfect. Before we save our G-code, we click the Return to 0,0 at End option, and then the 0 lower left button. As you see, our end mill is on the bottom left corner of our design, so we can now save it by clicking the Save G-code button. Step 4. Send G-code to Rabbit Mill. With the G-code downloaded on your computer, it is now time to start the SourceRabbit G-code sender. As soon as the G-code sender starts, select the appropriate communication port and then click the Connect button. You are now connected to your Rabbit Mill. Click the Browse button. Select the helloworld.gcode file and click Open. The G-code is now loaded and you can see it by clicking the Visualize button. Everything looks great, so we can send the G-code to our Rabbit Mill. Close the Visualize window and click the Send button. Your Rabbit Mill is now moving. Let's see the results. You just watched the 4 steps to turn a 2D design into reality using a few open source software and the Rabbit Mill Desktop CNC. Thank you for watching and see you at the next video.